Hello, this is John Locke, and today I want to answer a question that I've heard from time to time. What do you think is the best WordPress theme for SEO? Now, for those of you that don't know, WordPress is a very popular content management system and platform for building websites. I believe that right now, 33% of the websites that exist on the web utilize WordPress. Here's my answer to this. The best WordPress theme is going to be one that loads quickly. You don't want a bunch of unnecessary cruft or files downloading that you don't need, because site speed is very important to SEO and your customer satisfaction. They don't want a website to be taking 6 seconds to load each and every time. Also, the best theme for your particular needs is going to be one that you don't have a lot of difficulty editing with. Whatever your system is for publishing new content, that has to work for you. So that said, I want to just analyze some things that I've seen. Now, I'm going to preface this by saying that over the last 4 or 5 years, the majority of sites that I have built for myself, for my clients, as a subcontractor to bigger agencies, which I was doing up until a couple of years ago, the majority of those were custom-built sites. So I was using what we call a blank theme, like underscores or WP Rig. Back in the day, it would have been something like Starkers. It's basically a blank canvas with which to create exactly what you need, and that's it. Those are the majority of themes that I have created. Now, what I have seen my friends in WordPress and in web design use over the last few years, 2 years ago, maybe 3 years ago, a lot of people were using the Genesis theme. Now, Genesis is a theme framework that is developed by a company called StudioPress. And this came out, I believe it was inspired by another theme that was popular in the early days of WordPress called Thesis. Now, Genesis was like a version of Thesis, but better, more efficient. And it required a little bit more of developmental skill because of the way the theme was constructed. It was meant to really be developer-centric. Anyway, back to the story. A couple years ago, a lot of people were using Genesis with a beaver builder on top. And beaver builder is what we call a page builder. Now, if you've ever used a WordPress theme that's been bought off ThemeForest, you're probably familiar with a plugin called Visual Composer or WP Bakery, where you can add different elements to a page. Not quite drag and drop, but kind of like that. Beaver Builder is a very unobtrusive, not heavy on the extra code type of page builder. Now, a lot of people were using Genesis and Beaver Builder a couple years ago. What I am seeing most of my friends that are into web development, they're into building sites, they're into marketing, and they're heavily involved in the WordPress community. Most people that I'm seeing now are kind of turning toward a stack of Astra as the theme and Elementor or Beaver Builder as the page builder on top to modify content. I've used Astra for a couple sites. It's fine. It loads quickly for what it is. Now, I'm gonna say something else that's a little controversial. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't, but you be the judge. Most of the agencies that I know that are not doing custom development are buying themes off of a marketplace called ThemeForest, aka Envato, where you can buy what's called, not what I call, but you could buy basically what my friend Jonathan calls Swiss Army knife themes. So these themes are loaded with all kinds of cruft. And a lot of agencies rely on these. Most people who are do-it-yourselfers are going to buy one of the top 10 themes off of this marketplace, ThemeForest. And most of the themes that are up here are loaded with all kinds of stuff. There will be, you know, 3 contact form plugins and 5 slideshow plugins and, you know, 2 or 3 page building plugins. It's just complete overkill. And, you know, they might even have things like software in there for e-commerce and building forums. They're basically meant to literally be a Swiss Army knife theme. Now, what is terrible about these types of themes is when you load up a page on the end user side, like you're the end user and you're loading it up, a lot of these things are loading up in the background. So it's loading up all these files that power these extra things that you don't really need. And that is why I'm not a fan of pretty much anything that you're gonna find on the first page of ThemeForest, because all the most popular themes are loaded down with lots of extra cruft and crap and things that are basically gonna slow your site down and that most people are only gonna use 30% of it and the rest of it they don't really need. That's why I build custom themes to where it uses only what's necessary. And you're not loading up, you know, 3 slider plugins and on every page, and you're only using 1 slider on the homepage. Get my drift? Okay. So the best theme for you, one that you can use, one that's simple, one that's gonna load quickly. If you don't have a big budget for building a website, here's my advice. I wrote about this 4 or 5 years ago in an article on my site. I still believe it's true. If you don't have a big budget, you should hire somebody to consult with you that knows this stuff for an hour and have them help you pick a theme that's going to work well for your needs. If you only have like $250 to build a site, use some of that money to hire somebody for an hour and have them help you pick a theme. That's what I would do. Because otherwise you're gonna get loaded down with something that you're not gonna change for 4 or 5 years. And it's going to be really slow. It's gonna be loaded with stuff that you don't need. That's my thoughts. Second half of this question that I wanna address. Themes that are good for SEO. Now, some themes are out there that say this, and notably Genesis. So apologies in advance to all my friends that deal in Genesis for what I'm about to say. Genesis makes a lot of claims to being SEO friendly because it outputs structured markup, schema markup. So if you don't know what that is, Google structured data testing tool, and then plop any website into there and it will show you if there's structured data being output. So schema markup, micro formats, anything like that, it's gonna be output there. It's hidden markup in the code, but it serves a purpose. It tells Google information about that site, that entity, that organization. So if you're a company, a lot of times there will be metadata, that structured data being output about your company saying, this is your web address, this is your physical address, these are your social profiles. WooCommerce, I believe, does this as well. It outputs structured data about the product, you know, what category it is, whether it's in stock or not, the price, the SKU, different things, the description, the image. This is all data that Google uses to get a better idea of what a web page is about. Now, Genesis does output structured data, but the structured data that it outputs, and you can check this, is structured data saying, this is a website. Here's the header of the website. Here's the sidebar of the website. Here's the footer of the website. And in the larger scheme of things, I do not believe that this is super helpful for SEO. Google does know, or is smart enough to deduce. If you see this area at the bottom of each page and the top of each page, those are the header and the footer. It knows it's a website. So there are plugins that output structured data for you. Yoast is one of them. Well, you can set it up to either output data for you as a company, an organization, or as a person, like a public figure. So that's useful. There's another plugin that I will recommend. It's a free plugin, WP Structured Data Pro, by Phil Singleton's team out of Kansas City. I will put a link in the notes below. I want to sum this up by saying there's no right or wrong answer to what is the best theme for SEO. The things that I would avoid would be anything on page one of Theme Forest, most of it's garbage. Genesis is fine. There's nothing really wrong with it. It's pretty fast. I don't believe that the structured data that it outputs is insanely helpful. Might be negligibly helpful, but I don't believe that it really makes a big difference. But aside from that, anything that you can use to get your work done and that you're going to consistently publish with it is fine. Aside from that, just as long as it loads quickly, it's not loading cruft, should be good. Aside from that, it's really going to come down to the content on the page, the design of the site a little bit, the links coming into your site, and how your brand is being mentioned and linked to outside of your website. But more than anything, it's going to be the content on the page, more than the theme itself. As long as the site looks, you know, halfway decent and loads quickly, it should be fine. All right, that's my thoughts. Let me know if that's controversial or not. I'd love to hear your take on this. My name's John Locke. My business is Lockedown Design and SEO. We help manufacturing and industrial firms with SEO, so they get more RFQs. And we're publishing videos every week, so there's no reason not to subscribe. Until next time. Peace.